Hello students, this is the last video of organism and population and topic of today is commensalism and mutualism. So let's start. So what is commensalism? Commensalism is an interaction in which one species is benefited and other is neither harmed nor benefited. So, interaction in which one species benefits and other is neither harmed nor benefited is commensalism. Let us understand commensalism by example. Barnacles growing on the back of the whale is an example of commensalism. Now, barnacles are the crustaceans which grow on back of the whale. When whale swims in water, it delivers these barnacles to the food source. So, barnacles have an advantage because as the whale swims, these barnacles have access to microorganisms that float freely in water. So, as whale swims, barnacle get access to the microorganism that floats freely in water, which would otherwise be inaccessible to the barnacles. But whale is neither harmed nor benefited by the relation. So this is an example of commensalism. Now let us take other example of commensalism. Egret is a bird which is found close to where cattle is grazing. This is because as cattle moves, it flush out from the vegetation insects, which would otherwise be difficult for egret to find out. So as cattle flush out insect from the vegetation, these insects are eaten up by the egret. So egret is benefited as it could eat the insects which is flushed out from the vegetation by the cattle. But cattle is neither harmed nor benefited. Third example of commensalism is relationship between sea anemone and clone fish. Sea anemone has stinging tentacles in which clone fish lives. In this way, clone fish gets protection from its predators because predators of clone fish stay away from the stinging tentacles of sea anemone. Sea anemone is neither harmed nor benefited from the relation. So this is the third example of commensalism. Now let us study mutualism interaction. In mutualism, both the interacting species are benefited. For example, in lichens. Lichens are mutual relationship between fungus and algae. Fungus, it gets food from the algae and algae gets water and mineral from the fungus as fungus helps the algae in absorption of nutrients. So both are benefited. Fungus will get food from the algae whereas algae will get water and mineral from the fungus. Now let us study other example of mutualism, that is mycorrhiza. Mycorrhiza is a mutual relationship of fungus with roots of higher plant like glomus. Now fungus absorbs phosphorus from the soil and passes it to the plant. In this way plant is benefited and plant provide fungus with food by process of photosynthesis. In this way fungus is benefited. Relationship between fig and wasp is other example of mutualism. Female wasp use ovary of the fig plant as a site for egg laying. So female wasp, it uses the ovary of the fig plant to lay its egg. And in the process of egg laying by the wasp, the fig plant is pollinated. So both are benefited from the relation as wasp gets site for egg laying and fig plant is pollinated as a result. let us understand what is sexual deceit. Relationship between Ophrys plant and the bee is the example of sexual deceit. In the flower of Ophrys plant, one of the petal resembles like female bee. So one petal of Ophrys plant resembles female bee. So male bee perceives it as female bee and pseudo-copulates with the petal. During this process, Ophrys plant is pollinated. So in this way, Ophrys plant ensures pollination by the bee and it is the example of sexual deceit. So if you have gained something from this video, please subscribe now to my channel Ramji Chopra. Comment, like, and share.